Have you ever wondered if you could bomb a volcano and stop the lava flow? That's a question the people of Reykjavik, Iceland are probably asking themselves these days. And as it happens, it's been tried. About 86 years ago, in December 1935, the U.S. Army Air Corps actually did bomb a volcano. It happened in Hawaii. On the Big Island, Mauna Loa had erupted. Lava was threatening the nearby city of Hilo. Hawaii's leading volcanologist, Dr. Thomas Jagger, began holding regular press conferences to discuss the threat. At first, he called for calm. The lava was pooling harmlessly. But then, a week later, the northern side of the volcano's cone collapsed. A massive wave of lava poured down the slope, heading straight toward Hilo. Some ridge lines blocked the way, but by Christmas Day, the lava had burned straight through and was advancing at a rate of 1 mile a day directly toward the city. Dr. Jagger projected that Hilo would be buried in lava by January 9th. In other words, the city's population of 22,000 had just 2 weeks to evacuate, and if the wind shifted, even less time because of poisonous gases. As well, the city's fresh water system would be destroyed. That would plunge the Big Island into a serious water crisis. The situation seemed pretty bleak, but then another volcanologist, an Italian-American named Guido Giacometti, proposed calling the Army Air Corps to bomb the volcano from the air. Years earlier, they had experimented with explosives to divert lava flows, but the blasts were simply too small. If the Army Air Corps used larger bombs, Giacometti believed it could be done. The Army approved the mission, and Lieutenant Colonel George S. Patton went to work with his staff on the plan. And yes, that's the very same Patton you know from World War II. Nearby, on Ford Island in Honolulu, the Army Air Corps had two squadrons of Keystone bombers based at Luke Field. These were biplanes, but in 1935, they were some of the most advanced bombers the military had. Patton ordered 6 from the 23rd Bombardment Squadron, plus 4 more from the 72nd Bombardment Squadron, to fly to Hilo for the mission. Dr. Jagger selected precise targeting points in the lava field for each bomb. He advised that the bomb fuses should be set with a tenth of a second delay to ensure deep enough penetration into the lava to create the desired effect. They would fly in 2 waves of 5 planes each. Each plane would set 2 smoke bombs for targeting, and then circle back to drop 2 Mark 1 600-pound high-explosive bombs for effect. The plan called for 20 of the 600-pound bombs to be dropped in all, 4 directly into the heart of the volcano itself. The following day, on December 27th, the first wave took off at 8:30 a.m. 3 bombers from the 23rd Bombardment Squadron flew in a staggered V formation, while 2 more from the 72nd Bombardment Squadron followed in line of step. With the heavy bomb loads, the pilots struggled to get their planes above 12,500 feet of altitude. That was just 4,000 feet above the volcano itself. Later, one of the pilots, William C. Capp, recalled how each bomb threw up what he called a sheet of red molten rock almost 200 feet in the air. Tiny bits of molten lava burned holes in the fabric of the bomber's wings, and looking down, the bombardiers were dismayed to see that the lava simply flowed back into each of the blast craters that the bombs had made. It seemed a little bit like throwing rocks into a river, hoping to divert the flow. As for Dr. Jagger, he watched through a telescope from far away, while an Army photo reconnaissance plane took pictures to document the mission. Afterward, the results were tallied. 5 of the 20 bombs had hit precisely where Dr. Jagger had targeted them. Another 7 had missed, but were still in the wider lava field, and 4 were complete misses. Finally, 4 fell successfully directly into the heart of the volcano itself. The airmen knew full well that the mission was a failure. Meanwhile, the ground crews weren't happy about having to repair the lava damage to the planes. No additional bombing missions were flown. Weirdly, a week later, the lava flow stopped. Dr. Jagger declared that he, along with the Army Air Corps, had saved Hilo. He claimed that the lava had stopped when the bombs interrupted what he called The equilibrium of self-heating, whatever that means. That seemed pretty far-fetched, however, and other volcanologists at the time criticized his claims. Still, there was no arguing that the lava flow had actually stopped, and Hilo was no longer in danger. Still scratching their heads, the pilots and bombardiers accepted that maybe the bombing had worked after all. Medals were awarded, additional press conferences were held, and the story was good press for the Army. To commemorate saving Hilo, the 23rd Bombardment Squadron's unit patch was changed to depict a set of bombs dropping into a volcano. Still facing criticism from other scientists, Dr. Jagger wrote his findings into a formal study. He concluded, "The smashing of the tunnel had cooled the oncoming liquid so that it dammed itself. This confirmed the theory that the bombing solidified the tunnel lava back into the heart of the mountain. With 12 river hits out of 16, and liquid thrown up hundreds of feet, there can be no question whatever that the bombing stopped the flow." Modern scientists conclude otherwise. Frankly, it was all just a coincidence. The bombing was completely pointless, and the lava flow simply had stopped naturally. It was exactly as the Army aviators had known all along. But then again, they also knew enough to stay quiet. As a result, to this day, the 23rd Bomb Squadron's patch still features the volcano. Nowadays, they fly Boeing B-52H Stratofortress bombers out of Minot, North Dakota. They're part of America's Nuclear Deterrence Force. Looking back, however, maybe Dr. Jagger's theories weren't entirely wrong. Modern precision-guided bombs might just do the trick. In 1975 and 1976, the U.S. Air Force tried it out. They dropped 36 much larger bombs, 2,000 pounds each. Each bomb blasted a crater 30 meters wide. What they found was that the volcano's spatter cones were especially fragile to blast damage. The conclusion? Modern munitions should be enough to stop a lava flow. Of course, if you want to be sure, an atomic bomb should do it. But then again, you might shower the surrounding area with radioactive lava bits. So there you have it. If Reykjavik is threatened, nuking the volcano might just work. No guarantees, of course. I suppose there's a point where the bombing does more damage than the volcano. Further, I don't think most Icelanders would agree to it. Still, the 23rd Bomb Squadron might just yet earn that patch. I'm Thomas Van Hare, and this is Historic Wings. If you like these videos, please subscribe, click the bell for notifications, and give me a like. Please consider sponsoring us on Patreon or through PayPal. And remember, there's always more to the story.